A few final topics to talk about with regard to electrical circuits with just resistors in them until we get to a fun thing called capacitors, is that if you have a battery, a source of EMF, such as a battery, the most common one, we have generators that we'll talk about later that can generate EMF by using magnetic fields that are changing and all sorts of cool stuff. Anyway, but for now we'll talk about a battery. It causes an increase in potential. Yes. The whole thing about a battery is it causes an increase in potential, that charges on this side have more charges potential than this side, that there is an electric field that goes through the resistor that has high potential on this side and low potential on that side, so that positive charges are pushed through when there's really electrons moving the other way, but whatever. Okay, so the thing is, inside of a battery, inside pretty much any real device that is not a superconductor, at very low temperatures, there is always some sort of resistance, and that includes a battery. It has internal resistance. The charges have to actually work their way through the battery itself. They encounter some resistance inside the battery. And what that does is it causes a drop in potential. So even though the battery might be based on a chemical reaction that has a certain voltage associated with it, if you use that battery, you might find that you get a lower voltage than that. And so the way we imagine that, the way we create a model that makes sense, is we kind of separate the fact that there's an EMF caused by a chemical reaction, and there's an internal resistance caused by the fact that the battery itself has some resistance to the current flowing through it. We know that the... Sorry, just checking my notes here. We know that the voltage drop across the resistor, for this resistor here, this is where we're going to lose some voltage inside the battery. There's this EMF and then there's a voltage drop here. Well, that voltage drop is proportional to the current because V equals IR. So what happens is that the more current that's going through a circuit, the more current coming out of a battery, the more that voltage drop is going to be. So this internal resistance is more significant, the greater the current. So what this means, for example, is if you are running a little electronic device or a flashlight or something, generally this internal resistance will cause a very small drop in voltage because you won't notice, because the drop in voltage will be very small compared to the EMF. If, on the other hand, let's say you're trying to start a car, and a car has a battery in it with an electric motor, and the electric motor is used just to get the gas engine started. And that electric motor draws a lot of current. So what happens is that there's a huge amount of current, well, not huge, but, you know, a few hundred amps, which is a lot of current. And so you can have a drop in potential here enough that you can have a noticeable decrease in what we call the terminal voltage. And one of the ways you'll see that is if your lights are on when you're trying to start the car, you'll see the lights get dimmer. And you can sort of think of it as, the starting motor is taking more of the juice. But the real mechanism behind that is that the terminal voltage, the voltage between here and here, which is the voltage that's creating the electric field that's pushing charges through your headlights, is going to be less because it has been reduced by the voltage drop across that internal resistance. So what we do is we talk about the voltage on the outside of the battery, the voltage that you measure as the terminal voltage. The voltage you can see on the outside of the battery. The internal resistance of the battery is represented by this little R. We use a capital R normally for resistor, but in this case we use this little R. Then we have a voltage drop across the internal resistance is simply IR. Voltage drops are IR, so this voltage drop is no different. But this internal voltage drop decreases the voltage that you see at the terminal of the battery. So if there were no current going through here, then at the terminals of the battery, you would just measure the EMF created by the chemical reaction in the battery. But when current flows through, that is decreased by the voltage drop across the internal resistance. So it is decreased by IR, and R is the internal resistance, which of course is measured in ohms. I put hash marks around this because this is not a formula that you're going to see on a formula sheet because it's not really some sort of empirically verified or complicated formula. It's just a statement of the fact that the voltage is going to be reduced by the voltage drop caused by the internal resistance of the battery. So that's just a quick way of saying something conceptual that you should understand and be able to apply. Sometimes you will use it by sort of writing it out like that, and other times you will solve it in other ways. Like you can just think of this resistance as being in series with this, because it is. All the current that goes through this resistance has to go through this. So you may not always sort of find it useful to use this as a formula, but just a conceptual understanding of what's going on and why is it that even though you have a constant EMF caused by a chemical reaction, the battery might give a different terminal voltage. It might be giving a different voltage to the world. Okay, another thing about batteries, about electricity, is that they produce and transfer power, and power is the energy per unit of time. In mechanics, we said power is work over time. It's the rate at which you do work. And work is really about transferring energy from one thing to another. And so in more general sense, that's what it is. It's about the rate of energy transfer from one place to another. And it is supplied by the EMF. That's where the power comes from. To the power source of the power source is equal to the potential energy per unit. The potential energy per unit, let's see. Oh yeah, charge. So we can think of charges that come out of the positive side as having a certain amount of potential energy, just like something that's raised a certain distance above the ground has a certain amount of potential energy. And so the potential energy per unit charge is in volts, right? That's what voltage is, potential energy per unit charge. Sorry, it's the voltage in units of volts. Times the amount of charge per unit time. And what is the charge per unit time? Current in amps. Well, that's kind of clumsy the way that got divided on two lines, but whatever. Such is the way it is. So the power transferred is the power, because it gives it a certain amount of potential energy, and that potential energy will be used by the time it comes back to the battery. So it's a voltage is a certain amount of charge per unit, a certain amount of energy per unit of charge, joules per coulomb, times the amount of charge per time, and so we get the current times the voltage. Power is measured in watts. What is a watt? It's 1 joule per second. But you'll also notice that a watt is an amp multiplied by a volt, so it's also a volt amp. Although volt amp is used in a slightly different nuanced meaning in some more advanced stages of electricity, it's basically what you get when you multiply volts times amps together. So this is the power provided by a battery, the power provided by an EMF, or the power consumed by a resistor. So the power absorbed by a resistor, including the internal resistance, and converted to heat, that's what resistors do, or other circuit elements, which may convert it to other forms besides heat. And what other forms do we get? We get things like light, sound, kinetic energy. It can make things move. So whenever we have current going through a voltage drop, there is power being consumed by the circuit, which for a simple resistor will cause heat, but in other elements can create other things. It's transforming that electrical power into some other form of power, some other energy at a certain rate per unit of time. And since we're talking about batteries, it seems good to point out at some point, because this seems to cause some confusion, is that sources of electrical power, such as battery and wall sockets, what do they provide? They provide a constant EMF, a constant voltage. They do not provide a constant current. If I have a battery and I just hold it, the current out of that battery is zero. But if I put my terminals on the two sides of that battery, I'll read the voltage of the battery. It has that voltage. And if I then hook it up to a light, there might be some current coming out of that battery. And then if I hook it up to a motor that uses more power, it's going to have more current coming out of it. So the current is going to depend on what it's going to be attached to. It's going to depend on what we call the load in the circuit, but the EMF will remain constant. Now, sometimes we'll get a noticeable change in the terminal voltage because of the internal resistance. But in general, we have this constant EMF. And that applies not just to batteries, but also when you plug things in the wall. Everything you plug into the wall gets 120 volts. That's 120 volts of alternating current, which is something we don't talk about in great detail in this course, but it doesn't really make a big difference. The point is there is a EMF coming out of the wall. And so that EMF will be constant at 120 volts, and attaching different things to it will just result in different amounts of current coming out of that wall socket, but will not change the voltage.